Alan Dershowitz, Harvard Law Professor Emeritus and author of the book, The Case Against Impeaching Trump. He joins us now live in studio, which is great.
Yeah, nice to see you.
We always get you right in front of us. So the clock's ticking, the deadline's set. What happens?
She has to testify. And look, nobody should be referring to her as a victim or him as a perpetrator until we hear from both of them under oath, subject to cross-examination. There is nothing more essential to American justice than the opportunity to cross-examine your accuser, to confront your accuser. It's in the Constitution. Essentially, it goes back to Magna Carta. The idea that we're calling somebody a perpetrator and somebody else a victim based simply on he said, she said, is just wrong and it's un-American. She should testify. They should also call in judge and any other witnesses who were at the party, who claim they weren't at the party. Sure, let them broaden it beyond the two of them. As far as the FBI investigation is concerned, don't count on that. There's not going to be very much the FBI can do. First of all, it's not an alleged federal crime.
Right.
Second, the FBI doesn't make credibility judgments. All it does is investigate and try to get all the witnesses on board. So I don't think we're going to get much from the
FBI. What could the FBI do?
They could make sure they speak to judge. If judge refuses to speak to them, he's the other person who is allegedly in the room, jumped on her. The committee can subpoena him, and he can be forced to testify, and he's not going to claim any.
The allegation in the Washington Post is that the other guy knocked him off.
That's right, but he's there.
Not jumping on her, but
knocked him off.
Correct.
Ending
the contact,
right,
allegedly.
Right. Right. Look. It could have happened. It could not have happened. It could have happened involving a different person. It could have happened, but not the way she describes it. There are so many possibilities here. In the end, I think we're going to be stuck with she said, he said. I don't think we're going to get very much more. And then the American public is going to have to decide two things. Number one, who do you believe when you have a situation like this? And look, neither men nor women were born with a gene to lie or tell the truth. Women lie, women forget, men forget. These are very emotional issues. So that decision will have to be made. And then the second decision that will have to be made is, do you disqualify an eminently qualified person whose political views I disagree with, but he's eminently qualified, for something that allegedly happened 35 years ago? And then you combine the two. A, you'll never know for sure. B, it's 35 years ago. C, did Kavanaugh testify truthfully now? Those are the three elements. And in the end, you can't get to those elements without her testifying.
You mentioned the FBI. Guys, soundbite number three, Jay Sekulow and the jurisdiction. Apparently, the FBI, in his view, has no jurisdiction now, 36 years later.
The FBI has no jurisdiction over this kind of. Let's assume there, for the sake of this discussion, if there was illegality, and there's no evidence, Dr. Ford said there is, Brett Kavanaugh says they're not. That's not the FBI doesn't investigate that. What do? They do background checks. Now, this information is already public. So I think the appropriate thing to do here is to allow Dr. Ford to have the opportunity to address her allegations in a setting that she's comfortable with, whether it's publicly or privately, under oath.
Look, Jay is partly
don't
right.
Disagree with that. Do you think this happens on Monday?
I think it happens.
You
I think
do.
It has to happen
in
on
what?
Monday. If it doesn't happen on Monday, the Republicans will be able to ram this through by saying that she didn't come forward. Look, Jay, who's a great lawyer, is partly right and partly wrong. They have no jurisdiction to investigate a crime, but they do have jurisdiction to do a background evaluation. A background evaluation, I know we've all been asked. People come to you and say, do you know him? What do you think of him? They can do a background evaluation, but they can do it after her testimony. It makes much more sense for her to testify. She's not going to learn anything new from the FBI investigation. Her testimony won't change based on the FBI investigation. She testifies. If she provides new information, the FBI can look into it then.
You know, but you started out by saying very specifically how the Constitution works and how
right.
that is quite clearly being ignored here. Just to give you the extent of the rhetoric that is out there right now, here is a host on The View talking about this. Watch.
Men are supposed to protect you from these predatory males.
I do too.
And they're not doing that.
And believe
On
you.
On the contrary.
But we have
this,
to.
These people in Congress right now, in that Senate Judiciary Committee, these white men, old, by the way, mm-hmm. are not protecting women. They're
yeah.
protecting a man who is probably guilty.
You know, first of all, probably guilty isn't good enough under our system. And second, there's no indication other than her word that he's probably guilty. He may be. We have to know that. It's important. We don't want somebody on the Supreme Court.
The point she's made is that he's guilty and he has to prove himself innocent.
Look, that's what's happened today with the Me Too movement. In fact, in many respects, men are denied even the opportunity to prove their innocence. In colleges today, in universities, it's enough for a preponderance of the evidence. That means 51%. That means 49 out of every 100 people accused on a college campus and convicted may well be innocent.
Mm-hmm. Just to be clear, you believe she shows up on Monday?
I think she has to show up on Monday. If she doesn't show up on Monday, she has violated his core right to confront his accuser. If he shows up, what's he going to respond to? News reports. Right. She has to go under oath.
I don't think he shows up if she doesn't show up. As somebody said, they'll go at him like a pinata if she's not there. You heard whispers about this report in early August.
Yeah, there were rumors.
How many people do you think heard about these rumors then?
You know, Capitol Hill is a place of rumors. A number of people heard these rumors. They were very unspecific, and the word was, don't worry about it. It's gotten into the hands of the right people, and if there's anything to it, it will come out. But people knew about this on Capitol Hill well before the first stories appeared in the newspapers, at least knew that there was something going on. They didn't have specifics.
We're going to squeeze in a second story here. These FISA docs that are going to be made public anyway, we're going to get to that right now.
The declassification of these FISA documents, the president ordered it on Monday. Do the American people, do they have the right to see what's in these?
Talk about presumptions. There ought to be a strong presumption in favor of openness and in favor of the American people seeing everything. The only thing that shouldn't be seen by the American people are matters that would endanger national security. And we have to have a better process for classification, because I would say the vast majority of classified material today is classified to protect the reputation of people, not to protect the national interests of the United States. We have to disclose more. Transparency is the essence of democracy, and we need more transparency.
Last question here. General Flynn will be sentenced apparently after the midterms. George Papadopoulos was given 14 days in jail. Maybe he's out in 10 for good behavior. What does General Flynn get? After all of this, does he get a week?
What
is this worth?
I don't think he should get a day. I don't think he committed a crime. I don't think that what he said constituted the crime that he was pleading guilty to. I think he was threatened. I think his family was threatened. His children were threatened. If I had been his defense lawyer, there is no way I would have allowed him to plead to that non-crime.
Thank you for your time. Hope you come back. Alan Dershowitz.
Thank you very much, Alan. Nice to have you here.